In this video, I'll show you how to make a wheel that has spokes on it. I've already started a new sketch, and I have my origin here about the, I've created an axis about the origin. And I just want to sketch and dimension the cross section that I'm going to be revolving this. And make sure you constrain everything about the origin. Okay, so there's my cross section. I will use the revolve tool. So now I have the hub, and that's going to be the rim of the wheel, and I need to put spokes on it. And in order to do that, I need some work planes to work with. Let's just see what we have here to start with. That's perfect. I'm going to turn on my front plane. And I think, just for reference, I'm going to turn all these planes on. You'll see why when we start sketching. Now what I need to do is create a work plane here to generate the sketch for that spoke, and then I'll extrude from there. So I'll come up here to reference geometry, and we'll do an offset plane. Oops, try that again. Just put it over there, and it doesn't really matter where it is as long as it's somewhere in between the hub and the rim of that. So 2.5, that's totally fine. And I'm going to turn this one, this front plane, off. So that's the plane I'm going to sketch on. Now these are good references so I know my center lines in horizontal and vertical direction. So let's make a new sketch. That plane. Now the problem is you can't see where you are, so come up here to display style and you can turn on this where the hidden lines are visible. You can at least see what you're working with. Now the cross section of this spoke is a square, so it does get a little fuzzy here, but it'll work out as we go, as we get dimensions on it. And the width of those spokes is 3/4 of an inch. By 3/4 of an inch. I'm going to go ahead and also I want to center about the origin the spoke. So it's 3/4 wide and it's 3/4 tall. Oops. And I do want to get, again, I want to make sure. Pull that dimension out. There we go. Make sure you have that centered around the origin. Okay, so it's a little hard to see with that. I can turn my visibility back on, turn my shaded edges. Okay, so now you can see my sketch. What this will allow me to do is extrude. One of the extrude functions you have, the choice you have is when you extrude, is extrude to next. So I can take the sketch and I can extrude it up to here and it'll fit to that shape. And I can do the same thing that way. I can extrude it back and it will fit to that shape. And that's the correct way to do that. So we'll go to Features, Extrude. Click on your sketch. And what we'll do is, let's just go outside first. For our type of extrude, go up to next. That'll take it up to there. And then click on this box here where it says direction 2. And now we can do the same thing, up to next, and it'll extrude in both directions, and it'll fit to whatever that shape is. So that'll give us our first spoke. And now I can turn these planes off. I don't really need them. And now we'll just use a circular pattern. Remember, you're going to choose the feature that you want to pattern. It's going to be that one. And then come up here where it says direction and click on this inner diameter here, and that'll find the center. And then you just have to put how many you want. In this case, this object has 8 spokes. Say OK. And there's my shape.